What's it like going from in-person to digital? It was scary. I can tell you that when we first started that, it was really scary. Although it wound up being one of the best things we ever did. We've actually able to reach a whole lot more people virtually because, well, people can come to our workshops without having to buy a plane ticket. And ironically, right now they can't travel, but they come to our workshops all over the country, all over the world.
People. Yeah, and we were really nervous about how people would respond to that as far as, you know, are they going to feel like, are we going to get to know them? Are they going to get to know us and kind of our flavor and what we're like? But what we found was that it works. You know, you can actually connect with people digitally and through Zoom and still get to know each other and still have that really family feel. And it worked really well, but it was a lot of work getting it done because there were a lot of things we kind of had to transfer over from like on paper to in person and also to make the workshops very interactive so that people, you know, because 3 days on Zoom can feel like a long time.
Yeah.
But when the information is really valuable and really good, it just makes the days fly by, and people were just like really engaging and taking part and getting a lot of value out of it.
What we found when our flipping company had to go virtual too. Our flipping company had to go virtual too. We were already trying to figure out how to take our employees and have them work from home. We were already in our mind, we're thinking, we're going to outgrow this office here. We have to get bigger. So how are we going to do that? So we were already thinking that. Literally, I was about 2 months into the process when COVID hit. So that fast-tracked our plan big time. Right? So that was crazy, but the fast track to our plan. And when people were home, we actually hired some employees over Zoom. So I never met those employees except for over Zoom. We had a live pool party this summer at our house with about 10 people. But we had our team come over. We actually met some employees that came to our house that we only knew through Zoom. And you know what? It wasn't that different.
It was cool.
It wasn't that different. It was so strange that it was like they weren't totally foreign to us. And what we learned is that we all communicate a very different way, right? We all communicate, it's like 58% nonverbal. So facial expressions, body language, that's a big part of how we communicate. Only 7% is voice. So if you only met somebody over the phone, that's only 7% of you getting to know them. But when you see it, like you see us live, like you see our reactions, you see if I'm excited or if I'm pissed, or you can see everything when we're talking. So you get to know somebody. So when you meet them in person, if you meet somebody over the phone, like if you meet them in person, you've only known them over the phone, that's very strange. But if you meet that same person who you've spent 6 months or 3 months on Zoom, it's not that different.
We're finding that we're able to even do a lot of real estate transactions via Zoom or FaceTime.
Yes.
You know, we're contacting buyers that way. And, you know, with COVID, you can't go in their houses. We're doing a lot of real estate transactions that way, which is also really cool. I'm even able to design that way because even after we purchase the house, my project manager will go in the house and FaceTime me and walk me through the house, and I can make my design choices without ever setting foot in the house.